Happy day, children. Welcome back to class 5 EVS session, lesson 3, safety and first aid. In our earlier videos, we learned about the safety measures to be taken in case of fire accidents, and you also saw how to use a fire extinguisher. I hope now you will not become panic if you see a fire accident and will act wisely. Isn't it, children? You got that confidence, right? Now, in this video, we will learn about first aid. Accidents can happen no matter how careful you are. Many people do not know what to do when there is an accident or an injury. You should know what help should be given to an injured person. The immediate help given to an injured or sick person is called as first aid. What is first aid? The immediate help given to an injured person before we take him to a hospital is called as first aid. What are the main aims of first aid? To save lives, to make sure the condition of the injured or sick person does not become worse, to keep the injured person comfortable till proper medical help arrives. First, we should not become panic, and we should not make the injured person also become panic. Okay, so these are the main aims of first aid. It is very important for you to know what to do when an accident occurs. You should know about first aid, and also you should know when to give first aid and when not to give. You should give first aid only if the injury is small. For example, a small burn or a small scratch. Even then, an adult call for an adult. If the injury looks serious, for example, if the injury is inside the body and the injured person is in great pain, then there can be broken bones. What we call it as fracture, or it can be an internal bleeding also. In such a condition, do not try to give first aid yourself. Immediately call an adult for help, and you should rush to hospital. Now, in this video, we are going to see what first aid to be given in case of injuries like cuts and scratches, broken bones, sprains, animal bites, nosebleed, burns, fire and fire accidents. First, let us begin with what are the items present in the first aid box. So the first aid box contains scissors, medical tape, some painkiller tablets, cotton, antiseptic ointment. And antiseptic is nothing but a substance that prevents the growth of germs. Then you will have the band-aid, the tweezers, thermometer, bandage, gauze and safety pin. So these are the essential items that should be present in the basic first aid box. What is the first aid that you should give for cuts and scratches? So every one of you would have got some cuts and scratches when you are playing carelessly, isn't it? At that time, what first aid did your mother give? Yes. First, the person who is giving first aid should wash their hands before you help the injured person. So this will get rid of the germs which can enter the body through the cuts and wounds and cause infection. If the cut is small, wash it with soap or plenty of water or a clean cloth. Then dry the wound and apply the antiseptic cream. Then cover the wound with a clean plaster or bandage. So what you have to do in case of small cuts, you have to wash the wound with soap or water, then dry it and then apply antiseptic cream, then cover the wound with a clean plaster or bandage. If the cut is very deep and bleeding heavily, first wash the wound with water, then clean the area with soap. Then try to stop the bleeding by pressing down on the wound with a pad of clean cloth or cotton wool until the bleeding stops. If the wound does not stop bleeding, then a bandage or strip of cloth called tourniquet is used to cut off the flow of blood from the heart to the wound. It is wrapped firmly. So in case of deep wound, you have to rush to the doctor. The doctor may have to stitch the wound to close it. Now we will see what first aid should be given in case of fractures. A bad accident can cause a bone to crack or break. This is called as fracture. So what is a fracture? The crack or break of a bone is called as fracture. A fracture is very painful. It must be attended to by a doctor. The only first aid you can give for a fracture is to make sure that the part of the body where there seems to be a fracture is not moved. If the fracture is in the arm or hand, as you can see in the first picture, a sling, which is nothing but a cloth, is tied around the neck. Whereas if the fracture is in the limb or leg, strapping splints to the injured limb will prevent further damage by preventing the movement. However, this should be done only by someone who has had training in bandaging. So what is a sling? Sling is a cloth that is tied with the fractured part along the neck with a cloth. And what is a splint? Splint is a piece of metal, plastic or wood that is used to support a broken bone. Mostly splints are used if there is a fracture in the limbs. So in our next video, we will continue with the basic first aids that can be given for the remaining injuries. Till then, bye and thank you, children.